Hi.
Corey?
Yes, Corey, I'm pulling the quarry.
Yeah.
Hey, how you doing? How's it going?
Very well. Looking forward to getting a tattoo.
Oh yeah, what you looking to get?
Well, I'm interested in getting a skull and crossbones, but instead of crossbones, cross swords.
Cool.
And I was looking to get it on my shoulder, and I was looking more towards a nautical pirate theme.
And what kind of swords?
I'm interested in the Navy style swords. I was a naval officer for a number of years, so I wanted to, I have a sword I picked up in Spain. I wanted to use that style sword handle.
And do you want them going upward, probably? Like the handle's down and the sword's up like that? The skull in the middle,
that's perfect.
I'm going to do a little research and get the to get the handles right, and I'll maybe even do a little sketch.
All right.
Cool. All right, man.
Thank you very much.
Yeah, take 5 minutes or grab a coffee, whatever, and I'll be right with you.
Outstanding. Thank you, Corey.
Cool. Jeremiah, you want to come back?
Yeah.
You know, I sketched a couple out. I think it looks kind of good. Actually, the opposite with the swords going down. You like it like that?
Very cool with that. That's perfect.
Awesome, man. Just take that suit off.
Okay.
And I can put the stencil on.
Oh, yeah, that looks really good.
Yeah, there you go.
Great job.
Just looks like right where it's supposed to be, huh?
Perfect. I wouldn't change a thing.
Yeah. Good.
That's outstanding.
Right on, man. So what do you got to do to become an officer? Is that how you get that sword? Do they give you that once you become a...
Well, that was an optional piece of gear as part of a uniform, but for you know, the senior officer, it's required.
So you're a senior officer?
I am now.
How many years does it take to get that status?
I was commissioned back in 1993. After going to law school, came in, you know, as an ensign, became a Navy judge advocate, and spent just over 6 years in active duty and the balance in the reserves.
So what do you do now in the Navy?
Judge advocate general.
Oh, okay, there we go. Well, so you're an attorney for military personnel to get in trouble and stuff?
In the reserves, and then in my civilian capacity, I've kind of segued that into my civilian life. I represent, I kind of have a niche practice where I represent service members across the country and around the world, and you know, some of our war crimes cases that have come out of Iraq and Afghanistan. As a civilian counsel, I've been involved with some of the most significant cases that have come out of Iraq and Afghanistan. So I've had a number of very important cases coming out of the war.
So you're the defense attorney?
Correct.
Yeah.
I represent our war heroes over there.
Yeah. Yeah, it's kind of scary to even think that they'd have to defend themselves in those situations. You know? See what the... Well, that's a trip. So how long has it been since you've actually been out on the boat, out to sea? Did you ever do that?
Well, I...
like in the beginning?
Primarily in the courtroom. I have been on ships, but it's never ship's company, but I've been on flown out to aircraft carriers, and when I was living overseas, traveled extensively throughout the Europe and Southwest Asia and the Adriatic, and wherever the ships went, you know, the Jags would follow behind.
Just there's always something, there's always some type of...
There could be.
Wow, what a trip. Did they have like court on the ships?
We've done actually court martials on ships.
So what's up with the Jolly Roger here? Or the...
Well...
It doesn't have the bones. It's got the nice military swords there.
Well, being a Navy guy, I really have a fine appreciation for the Jolly Roger and the, you know, the traditional Navy tattoos, old school tattoos. And
you guys have kept it alive, man. That's part of the culture right there. The
but
Navy.
I put a little twist on, instead of the crossbones, I have the crossed swords.
Yes. So when you, these swords, that's for like a full dress uniform, huh? Like,
right, it'd be for a ceremonial in nature. Well, a number of my friends have joked with me that I've been living a pirate's life, having traveled so much to various ports when I was on active duty, and still today, because I have cases, in the Middle East, all across the country, and it's one port call after another, and and my work is done in the courtroom at these ports, but it's been exciting, and I've truly been blessed, and I'm real lucky to represent our service members.
Well, you definitely you have embraced that statement now, living the pirate's life, because you got a pirate tattoo now.
Yes, I do.
Pirate Navy tattoo, that's good. Yeah. All right, we are ready.
All right, let's take a look.
Take a look. Tell me what you think, man.
Oh, that is over the top. Detail is incredible.
Think you boys will like it?
I like it a lot. The detail is unimaginable. On Corey's advice, we elected to put in a little bit of flair. We did that with a gold tooth and a gold earring and a red bandana. It took that tattoo to the next level. When I wake up in the morning and you know, look at this tattoo in the mirror, it's going to remind me of many ports that I visited over the past 16 years, but also more important, you know, my future battles in our courts for our service members around the world.
All right, Jeremiah.
Hey, Corey, thank you so much.
Thank you, man. My pleasure, my privilege.
I knew it was going to be outstanding, but it's just over the top. I'll be proud to wear it and all the port calls in the future, and I'll never forget.
I hope all your friends approve.
They will.
All right, man.
Hey, thank you. Take care.
Yep.